You still hanging around?
Let's say I'm beginning to fancy Oakdale.
Well, bully for you, Kitty. If you don't mind, I have to go change. I'm having dinner with Connor tonight.
Oh, I remember our dinners in England. All those romantic little country inns.
Oh, I bet you do. But you know, it's so nice to be eating with someone now that I can trust. Someone who doesn't play games.
Well, I hope you don't trust Miss Walsh with too many business secrets. Like that one about Boston, for instance.
That was good. That was good. Where'd you get that?
Oh, I'm not finished, no. No, you went to Boston for Lucinda Walsh, and you met a, Lee Hemingway there.
Right. And you heard all that when you stopped by Lucinda's office, right?
Think about it, darling. Do you really think she'd tell me important business secrets? No. I heard it right here. I recognized Connor Walsh from seeing her arrive for the ball with you. She was talking to a very good-looking man. I suppose he was her business associate. He was very agitated. He kept asking her if she knew anything about your business trip. And she said, your trusted and loyal companion, Miss Walsh, she said that she remembered you going to Boston and meeting with Lee Hemingway.
Here, let me help you with that.
I just had no idea the whole thing was missing.
Yeah, Julie, it was about a month ago. I just assumed that you would have heard it from Andy or Lisa or somebody.
I told you I hadn't been in touch with any of them.
Well, the whole family's worried. You can imagine what Lily's going through. He just disappeared. He had a fight with Lily, and we haven't heard from him since. He called her twice, once at M&A, but the line went dead before she could pick it up. And then he left a message on her service saying that he was okay, but that was about it.
I can't believe this.
All we can think is that it's something very serious, an accident or something. The police are looking for him, and Lucinda's hired some private detectives, but all they've been able to figure out is that the calls he placed came from somewhere outside of Pittsburgh. Other than that, it's like he fell off the face of the earth.
Sorry, I don't mean to, like, fall
Julie,
to pieces
Julie,
like this.
It's
just...
I understand. I know how much you care about Lily and Alden. I'm sorry you're taking it so hard.
Be seated. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man Duncan and this woman Jessica in holy matrimony. Jessica and Duncan would like to begin this joyous occasion with a song that has a special meaning for them. Their friend Kira Johnson will now honor us with that song.
And I'll be there for you, like you've been there for me a thousand times. I'll do just as you've done for you who brought me love. It's you who brought me love. How many times in your life do you find a lover who's a loving friend? Never asking for anything more. Who's there in the end? Now I touch your face, holding you tonight, knowing we've got tomorrow, and for all we've come through, we'll get by. These words won't say enough for you who brought me love. It's you brought me love. It's you who brought me love. For you who brought me love. Cause you brought me love.
Dealing with it?
Well, the first few days after Holden's message, she assumed that he would come back, or at least call her and tell her that he was safe, but he didn't, and she's taking it real hard, you can imagine. We all have to just assume that something very serious has happened. Lily's not working full-time anymore. She's pretty much given M&A over to Ellie and Emily.
Emily? Emily's back in Oakdale?
Yeah, Julie. You don't know that? You and Emily have always been very good friends.
Well, I told you, Caleb, that I haven't been in touch with anyone.
Why, Julie? You know, when I called Ron, he said that you were so busy with your modeling and your planning your wedding that you couldn't talk to anybody. I almost didn't try to reach you again.
Maybe you shouldn't have, Caleb. You...
Well, if you feel that way, maybe you should have just told me that you were too busy or something.
Well, maybe I should have. It's just when I heard your voice and I knew you were going to be here in New York. I just couldn't help myself. Story of my life.
Don't put yourself down, Julie.
So, when you called, you said that it was very important that you see me. Why?
Yeah. Yes, it is, actually. It was Angel's idea. I agreed with her. Being that our marriage broke off with you running off and the fact that we haven't seen each other in quite some time, we thought that it was important that we saw each other and tried to put our past behind us.
That Angel's one in a million. You're a lucky man.
Yes, I am. Well, we both have our drinks and they're not spilled. What would you like to toast to?
You decide.
How about Holden? Pray that he's safe and that we find someone who can help us find him.
And Miss Walsh, your loyal and trusted companion, told her business partner
that she remembered you'd met with a Lee Hemingway in Boston.
Scott?
Sorry it took so long. I'm glad we're going back to that little French restaurant. Sort of think of it as our special place. You've been so quiet tonight. I'm all the way out here.
I just got a lot on my mind.
So what should we drink to?
How about honesty?
Honesty?
Yeah. I was trying to remember the conversation we had about my trip to Boston. And I couldn't remember if I'd mentioned anything about a woman, Lee Hemingway.
Yes, you did mention it.
Well, my next question is, you didn't by chance pass that information along to Kirk, did you?
Oh God, we ask your blessing on this man and this woman who are now here to be joined as one. Give them patience in their times of stress and gentleness toward the angers that would destroy them. Deepen them in faith toward thee that theirs shall always be a household filled with praise. And if it is thy will, bestow on them the blessing of children. Amen. If any of you can show just cause why Jessica and Duncan may not lawfully be wed, speak now or else forever hold your peace. Will all of you witnessing this ceremony do all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage?
We will.
Jessica and Duncan have some thoughts they want to share with one another in the presence of their family and friends as they give and receive the rings that symbolize their unbroken circle of love.
Jessica, since you told me you'd do me the honor of becoming my wife, we've faced many obstacles together. Not the least of which was our trip to Edinburgh and our trip to New York. You gave me the opportunity then, and the time, to make a thoughtful decision about our future together. And that was the greatest gift of love you could have given me. When you left, and I was alone, I realized I had no great decision to make. All I had to do was follow my heart. And it led me right back to you. And I'll never stray. You are my rock. My safe harbor. My love. Always.
Duncan. I remember the first time I admitted my love for you. We were on a plane going to Scotland. On an earlier trip. And we talked about the journey we were about to begin together. That was over a year ago. And in the time that's passed, the journey hasn't been easy. We've had many challenges to face, but I never doubted. Not for one instant. We could overcome them because we were together. And our love was stronger than all the obstacles that stood in our way. And I know that our love is stronger than anything we could encounter in the future. You are my companion on this journey. You are my partner, my friend, and my love.
Now that Jessica and Duncan have given themselves to each other by vows and the joining of hands and giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Duncan, you may kiss your bride.
Scott, I don't blame you for being angry, but if you would just let me say something in my own defense. It's not as though I hurried to Kirk with this information. He was desperate. Adelaide Fitzgibbon is one of his dearest friends in the world, and his interest in this was purely personal. Walsh is not going to profit from this at all, and I knew that when I gave him the information. He would have found Lee Hemingway on his own, even if I hadn't.
How? How? You don't know that.
No, not for certain. I was in such a difficult position. Kirk is very close to me, and I owe him so... I don't know what else to say. I'm very sorry about this.
So am I, Connor. It just changes everything.
Where are the boys?
Carl! Carl! Leon, come on over and be in the picture!
Come on, baby!
Leave him alone!
Leave him alone!
Leon,
go to the
boys!
Yeah.
Take over.
All right, no, I have something for you guys.
You too.
Here, these ought to keep you busy.
Oh, yeah. What do you say?
That's very thoughtful.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Now we always know where to be humble.
Hi. Is Courtney here?
Yeah, I just saw her in the powder room.
Oh, I better wait out here. I know I'm crashing the party, but Mom told me that you said it would be all right with the newlyweds.
I'm so sorry that your mother's not here.
Yeah, I asked her to come, but she had too many things to do to get ready for the move, so...
She's so excited about it.
Yeah.
Will you excuse me? I want to congratulate Kira on her singing.
Well, good to see you.
Yeah.
I have fabulous news.
Well, I think you ought to talk to Courtney.
Well, it's about business, and it wouldn't mean anything to Courtney. I have an entree to Alexander Cabot. His private office number and his secretary has been ordered to put my calls through.
How did you manage that?
What are you doing here?
I crashed the party. I was crazy without you.
You look terrific.
Hey, I hope you're taking notes for our big day.
Not exactly. We're going to have a simple ceremony.
Well, but we'll have like a big reception, right? You know, where people can really kick up their heels and enjoy it.
We're going to have a simple reception.
Want to play?
Yeah.
Well, come on. Step out.
Now, Duncan, of course I'm all for hiring Lamar. I think it's a wonderful idea, but couldn't we put him in some sort of a training program?
That's just the point. Howard Lieberman has been begging me for a sales assistant for months. Lamar could train right on the job.
I could train on what job with whom?
Lamar, how would you like to be assistant to the head of sales at the Argus?
Duncan, it's my obligation as your best man and also my pleasure to inform you at this time you should be dancing with your bride.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
Very nice.
Mrs. McKechnie, may I have the pleasure of this dance?
Certainly, Mr. McKechnie. You like the way that sounds.
Thank you. Oh.
Yes.
Yes, I'm happy. I'm happy that I'm your wife. Happy that I'm having your child. And I love you so very much.
Oh, please, everyone, join us. Please, join us.
Just a moment, honey. Be patient.
Can we go swimming?
No, honey. The pool is closed.
If our boys were here, they'd be asking the same thing. Oh. Pool and cake, right?
That's true. You know what? When we get to New York, why don't we all get together and take the boys swimming?
Oh.
What do you think? Good idea? You'd like that?
Yeah.
Yes, you can. Oh, my goodness.
It's true. Fiona. Where are you going? Would you care to dance?
Yes, I'd love to. Where are you moving?
All right. Now tell me about these things. What are these? Whistles are for their foods.
You know, I'm very glad that you came this evening, even though I'm sure this wedding has brought up lots of memories.
Yeah, it has, but I believe that Holden meant everything he said when we exchanged vows, and that we'll bring him home soon.
That's all right. Thanks anyway. I'll see you guys later.
You're beautiful. It was quite a ceremony, huh? Kept thinking about our wedding. How about you?
It's hard not to.
Hi, you two.
Hi, Lucinda. Excuse me, I'm gonna go find Kira.
When are you going to come over to my office and talk to me about DeWitt, huh?
Lucinda, business is the last thing on my mind right now.
I'm so glad to hear that Mark was going to counseling.
Thank you, I am too. You know what? I'm thinking about looking for a group for husbands of rape victims.
It's a good idea. I know this has been rough on you, too.
Yeah, thanks, Dad.
Hi, darling.
Hi, we were just talking about you.
Ooh, you look
what
so
do you
pretty.
Say? You and I go show them how this is done.
Well, this is done? This is done? Hey, Mac.
Yeah.
I know I'm supposed to report back tomorrow, but I think I'm going to hold off a few days.
Hey, you take as much time as you need.
Sorry to bother you,
Mark.
I got some news on the two guys that attacked Margo.
Dan, excuse me, I want to go and talk to Fran.
Oh, sure.
Murphy, anything new on the case? Find the van yet?
Yeah, we found it in the river. It's about 6 miles south of town. Some kids were swimming down there and spotted it. We're going to need you to ID it.
You okay?
Yeah, I think I'm going to ID that tomorrow.
Sure. You say, yeah. What about your informant?
Well, he's still convinced that Nevins and his accomplice haven't left the state yet, but he's using all of his contacts to track him down.
I saw you talking to Daryl a little while ago.
Yeah, this has been kind of hard, Graham. It's been hard for both of us. I think it just brings back memories of our own wedding.
Franny, I wish I understood what has happened.
Graham, it's not really anything that I can go into now, but I got a letter from Gavin Kruger, and he said some really awful things about Daryl.
Well, you wouldn't believe anything that Gavin Kruger would write to you, would you? Franny, have you fallen out of love with Daryl?
No, Graham, I don't think I have, and I realize that now, but that's what makes it so hard. I mean, I'm afraid to give in to my feelings because I think that what Gavin wrote in his letter could really be true.
I just called Mama, and she and Bianca got Linda, Ann, Stephen, and Aaron all asleep.
And how are they doing?
Well, they're still standing, barely.
Excuse me, Ellen. Sorry, you have a phone call.
Oh, I do. Okay. Hello? Kirk, hi. What a surprise. When are you coming home, if ever? Yeah, I am upset. I just called Mama, and she said that you called your children, and they were already asleep. You know what, Kirk? This might be a really great time for you to think about something. What's more important, your business opportunities or your children and your wife?
Lily, can I speak to you for a moment? I know you've got very good reason not to trust me, but I just wanted to say how sorry I am about Holden and that he was one of the fairest, most decent man I've run across in the business world.
May I have your attention, please? Please join us. As best man, it is my honor and my privilege to offer a toast to the new bride and groom. Margot and I were among the first to know that Duncan and Jessica had actually fallen in love, and we've been able to be part of that joy and happiness since that time and throughout this entire ceremony. All I can say is, if their marriage brings them half the happiness that mine has, they will be forever and truly blessed. To Duncan and Jessica.
Duncan and Jessica.
All right, now cut the cake. Go ahead. Okay, let's go. Yeah.
Nice toast of Tom's. Now, your new son has quite a way with the ladies.
But I think he and Connor make a lovely couple.
Connor. I wasn't thinking about Connor.
I met Kitty Fielding today.
We were so good together. Do you know, there are some nights I can't sleep remembering how it was, lying in your arms, feeling you next to me. You were the most wonderful lover I've ever known. Oh, darling, rubies. Oh, they're gorgeous. Oh, I adore them. Can you afford these?
For you, of course I can, anything.
Do you mean that? Would you do anything for me?
Yeah. Just ask me. Anything you want.
Just be patient, Kitty. You know all the right buttons to push.
Well, that's an awful fancy bathroom you got. I was tempted to open that door in the hallway. I guess that's Lisa Ann's nursery.
So you haven't told me about Iva. Have she and John set a date yet?
No, not yet, but they will soon. Actually, they're in L.A. right now in a convention. Maybe they'll stop by Las Vegas on their way home, just like
we did. Excuse me. Hello?
Hi. How's my Julie bug?
Ron, hi. How's the shoot going?
Well, we're running late. I'm gonna have to stay over. They're putting up the models and the crews overnight. Hey, any chance you could come out? I can send in the limo for you.
I'm too tired.
You don't sound tired. You sound sort of hyper to me. You haven't been on the phone with anyone from Oakdale, have you?
No, I told you I wouldn't.
Good. Sure you won't change your mind?
Since we are getting married out here, we can talk to the caterers tomorrow, go over all that.
How about if I come out in the morning?
Okay. I'll call you before I turn in. I love you.
Same here. Bye, Ron.
Julie, you had said that Ron was going to make you give up some things. You meant your friends in Oakdale, didn't you?
Ron's not just jealous of the men. He's jealous of all the friendships that I made back there. He wants me to make a clean break.
I don't think that's a very good way to start a marriage. If Angel was that way,
Well, okay, so Ron's not Angel, right? But it's for the best.
But it's not what you want.
No, but it's what he wants.
And you love him enough to just go along with it?
upset seeing Evan and Courtney like that?
Well, I'm a little upset, yeah, especially since that Evan slept with Emily while Courtney was away, and I know it.
Well, you didn't tell her that, did you?
No, I took your advice.
Okay.
But it doesn't make it any easier knowing.
Huh?
Franny's over there alone. Yeah. Why don't you ask her to dance?
Think so?
Yeah.
All right. Hi. Well, thanks to your brother, I got the courage to come over and ask you to dance.
Hi.
How are you two?
Hi.
You know, I've been waiting for months to see you two dance at my wedding. Why aren't you out there? How about it?
Sure. Great.
I know you're only doing this for Duncan and Jessica's sake.
I don't want them to know about our problems tonight. That's the only reason I said yes.
But I don't know anything about advertising. What if I can't cut it?
Duncan must believe that you can learn on the job. Anyway, he's your brother-in-law now. He can look out for you.
I don't want to be beholden to him in that way.
Lamar, don't look at it like this. Look, this is your shot. Take it. Besides, I want you here in Oakdale with me, buddy.
Right, buddy. I hope you have something to tell me.
What's going on? Is there something? I don't know.
Yes, I believe your husband has a lot of big surprises.
So, what's it going to be, Lamont? I just have one question. When do I start?
Good man.
Wait a minute. Start what?
Oh, well, you are looking at the new assistant to head of sales at the Argus.
Why didn't you tell me about this?
Oh, I just thought it would be a nice wedding surprise. I want to talk to you. Excuse us.
Uh-huh.
Honey.
Mm-hmm.
It was me.
Oh. I'm so glad you were... You have to leave.
Yeah, we have a plane to catch early in the morning.
Well, I'm so glad you could come. I'll talk to you soon.
Okay. Hey, we're gonna have to go too.
Oh, everybody's going.
No. The boys are tired.
Okay.
It's a beautiful wedding, honey. And I'm glad we were all together.
I'm glad too. I'll see you.
I will see you and the boys back to the Mitchell Center.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Well, you were some best man, Tom.
I know, honey.
You've always been my best man.
Well, thank you.
Hey. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to startle you.
All right.
I came over to ask you to dance.
Well, sure. It'll be like our high school prom.
Well, not quite like the high school.
Okay, Mom, then what about it?
Well, what about?
I saw you dancing with Franny.
Yeah, I hope she's softening up a little bit.
I just wish you could tell me the explanation you gave to Franny for your dealings with Candace.
I'm going to tell you everything, but I don't think it's the right time. I don't want to burden you with it right now, okay?
That's a nice dress. Does she wear clothes more often? Mm-hmm. What's that supposed to mean, Mom?
Just that the last time I saw you here, you were parading around nude, practically. In a teeny little bikini you wore after the AIDS ball. Remember the night you and Evan cut out so early?
Excuse me, Mom. I think I'm going to go find someone to chat with who's a little less critical. Excuse me.
What was that all about?
I just tried to give her a little motherly advice.
She didn't take it very well.
Lapped it up.
I was talking to Ellie, and I think we need to bring Evan Walsh on board. But you are sure this isn't going to cause more problems for you and Kirk?
I'm not worried about Kirk, so you shouldn't be concerned.
Girls, the timing couldn't be better. Evan just told me he has an entree to Alexander Cabot.
As in Cabot Motors?
We get that account, we'll put Evan in charge of it.
No, wait, we need somebody to cover Meridian.
Ellie, after working with you these past few weeks, I think he can handle a lot more than public relations. I'd like to put you in charge of Meridian.
What?
I can see that.
Wow.
Can I have this dance?
Sure, why not?
How are you holding up?
It's okay.
certainly a lot better than I was when I had the eighth ball.
Well, you look terrific. But then you always do.
Evan, listen, I don't want to keep you from Courtney, but if you stop by M&A tomorrow, we're prepared to make you an offer. So as soon as Kirk gets back, you can give him your notice.
Emily, this is great. I don't know what to... Thank you. Oh, you are sensational. I won't forget this.
My friends, may I have your attention, please? First of all, Jessica and I would like to thank you all very much for sharing this incredible evening with us. And right now we regret to say that we're going to leave you, although I can't say I'm too upset about that. Please continue to enjoy the facilities, dance, and have a great time till the wee hours of the morning. Right now, we'd like all the single ladies to form a little half circle here. And Jessica has something for one of you.
What about you?
Oh, come on, I'm too old for this.
You're not too old for anything. You're not married yet, so get out there and catch that thing for both of us.
Come here. Hey, Mama.
Yeah. All right, ladies, are we ready?
Yes, we're ready.
Meeny, meeny, miny, mo.
Look, with them.
Sorry I stayed so late, Julie.
No, it's all right.
Hey, I'm staying in Seth's apartment if you want to call me.
I don't think we should see each other again, Caleb. We're both starting out in new marriages and... Well, I wish you all the happiness in the world. All that you deserve, and that's a lot.
I wish you the same.
Thanks. Angel's gonna be a wonderful wife.
I'm just sorry that Ron's making you cut all your ties back home. I just don't think that's fair.
It's for the best.
How about a goodbye hug, huh?
I defended you more than once to Lucinda. Now, how do I face her, the boss lady, and tell her she was right?
Well,
what is it, Scott? What is it?
I know it's late. Matthew said you were still at the reception, so I thought I'd wait.
Well, Matthew forgot about you. He just told me about it. What is it that you need me for that cannot wait till morning?
This.
What is this?
It's my resignation.
It was so wonderful seeing you and Franny dance together.
Yeah, I think she may be finally getting over some of the things that have happened.
And I think it's a very good sign that she refused to talk to Gavin Kruger when he called.
What call?
Oh, Cam got a phone call from him at the house today. Franny refused to talk to him.
Well, that could only mean one thing. He wants to tell her about Barbara and Jennifer.
I'm afraid you're right.
Do you mind if we... Okay, great. Could we cut in?
Good thing you're with Lisa.
I've got an idea. Now that Jessica and Duncan are gone, why don't we go get Carrie and the three of us will go back to the house alone, together. And maybe I can finally convince you to get rid of all these doubts you have about me.
And for all we've come through, we'll get by.
I've nothing here but love.
It's you who brought me love.
most beautiful woman in the world, and you're my wife. I love the sound of that word, wife.
I love the sound of the word, husband.
Today was the happiest day of my life.
Mm. It's not over yet.
Oh, yes it is. It's midnight.
Well, that just means that this is the first day of the rest of our married life together. Jessica. Wife. I love you.
And I love you.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you by new Lifesavers Holds. Get what you've been missing. Ray-Bans by Bausch & Lomb. Join us tomorrow for As the World Turns.